Today, we're printing three boards for a project designed by our authorized reseller in South Korea, ITIZ. This project helps students to learn the basics of electrical design theory, PCB printing, and PCB assembly. The first PCB in the project is the voltage regulator circuit. This board is designed to teach students about different voltage regulators by demonstrating how to convert the voltage from a 9-volt battery down to 5 volts. Here's a quick overview of the two types of voltage regulators we will be using today. First is the linear voltage regulator, which works by taking an input voltage, dissipating excess energy as heat, and outputting a stable voltage. This kind of regulator is good for low power applications, as they tend to be inefficient. The other regulator on the PCB is a switching voltage regulator. In this project, we are using a step-down buck converter, which is a type of switching regulator that takes a high voltage input and outputs a lower, stable voltage. It does this by rapidly turning a MOSFET or transistor on and off. Switching regulators are more energy efficient than linear regulators, but the trade-off is a much noisier output, which makes them less ideal for sensitive circuits in radio and sound equipment. The second PCB is a continuous pulse generating circuit. It's designed to take the output of the voltage regulator circuit and convert it to continuous electrical pulses. This circuit works by utilizing a 555 timer in astable or continuous mode, which allows us to set both the width and frequency of the pulse using resistors and a capacitor. Here, we've used a potentiometer, a type of variable resistor, which will allow us to adjust the timing of the pulse by adjusting the resistance value of the potentiometer. The pulse generated from this circuit will be sent to our third and final PCB, a 99 decimal counter with two 7-segment displays. The third board teaches students how the various components of the circuit work together to allow the 7-segment display to count up to 99. This circuit first uses two 4-bit counters. The first 4-bit counter receives the pulses that were generated in the previous board. The counter was configured into a basic hexadecimal counter, which then utilizes an AND logic gate to reset at 9 instead of 15. This will output the number of our unit place, also known as the numbers in the ones place. When the first 4-bit counter resets from 9 to 0, its input signal triggers the second 4-bit counter to change the number in the tens place. The signals from these two counters are sent to two separate 7-segment drivers, which decode the binary values and display the corresponding digits. After the 99 decimal counter is finished, the students can control the speed of counting by changing the resistance on the pulse generating circuit. This three-board project is a perfect way to get students from theory to hands-on work in electrical engineering. Designed for ease of use, students can progress from design to a functional PCB assembly all in the same day with V1.